Hi, I am Ufuk. It's an honor for me to give a contributor talk in this virtual technical conference. The title of my talk is Plasma-Enhanced Atomic Layer Deposition of Zinc Oxide Ultra-Thin Films Monitored by In-Situ Spectroscopic Ellipsometry. Before diving further into my focus research subject, let me give a brief introduction about the big picture. The wide range of interesting electrical, optical, and photocatalytic properties make zinc oxide ultra-thin films attractive for photovoltaic, electroluminescent, and optoelectronic device applications. Our motivation dates back to one of the first papers from our group that reports extremely birefringent, spatially coherent slanted columnar thin films which was grown via glancing angle deposition technique. It is found that the ultra-thin conformal aluminum oxide deposition over such high aspect ratio structures leads to highly stable optical properties which is not affected by its exposure to the ambient environment. Moreover, tailoring the optical properties of such nanostructures is also predicted as another positive motivation on the deposition of two-dimensional ultra-thin transition metal oxide films. As a counter-argumentative envision, such nanostructures can also play a natural masking technology that can simply turn this flat thin film growth mechanism into three-dimensional structures which might potentially tailor the inherent physical properties of transition metal oxide ultra-thin films as well. Here is our existing ALD system. To closer look onto the main chamber design, here is its schematic illustration. In our system, we integrated the spectroscopic ellipsometer to monitor the growth process during the deposition. In brief, ellipsometer is a contactless, damage-free, non-disturbing optical characterization technique which employs the light source with a known polarization state, and its interaction with the surface of the sample of interest will lead to the change in the polarization state of the incoming beam that is stored in terms of ellipsometer parameters, so-called psi and delta. While tangent psi is the amplitude ratio upon reflection, delta is known as the phase shift. With its ultra-high sensitivity nature, spectroscopic ellipsometry is an excellent technique for investigating the kinetics of precursor material surface interaction during the ALD process. Atomic layer deposition is a thin film deposition technique based on sequential use of a gas phase chemical process. The majority of ALD reactions use two chemicals called precursors. These precursors sequentially react with the surface of a material one at a time in a self-limiting manner, and they are separated from each other by a purging mechanism. The cyclic precursor surface interaction results in the assembly of the desired materials on the surface at the end of each ALD cycle. The spectroscopic ellipsometry is an excellent tool to monitor such complex but discretized surface modifications. However, it requires a well-defined best match model calculation in order to turn the ellipsometry data into physically meaningful parameters. Recently, we found that a five-phase model with two dynamic parameters is sufficient to explain in-situ spectroscopic ellipsometry data measured within and across multiple cycles during the plasma-enhanced atomic layer deposition of metal oxide thin films. In this study, we reported that our dynamic dual box model for the analysis of in-situ spectroscopic ellipsometry data measured over the large numbers of cycles during the growth of titanium oxide and tungsten oxide thin films as examples. The tungsten oxide ALD recipe is schematically illustrated, and here is the resulting single cycle time evolution of dynamic void fraction and thickness parameters of tungsten oxide thin film, which is overlaid with an arbitrarily selected corresponding psi and delta evolution. And here is the same panel for the titanium dioxide ALD process. As a consequence of cyclic exposure to precursor materials, we observe that cyclic surface roughening with fast kinetics and subsequent roughness reduction with snow kinetics. This process leads to the oscillation of the thin film thickness with small growth per cycle. Here, we would like to use this knowledge and study the in-cycle kinetics of zinc oxide ALD process. However, at first, ALD technique requires a well-defined recipe in order to obtain continuous material growth with desired stoichiometry. Here are the details of our zinc oxide ALD recipe, which employs a pre-plasma cleaning treatment of substrate, followed by a temperature stabilization process of reactor chamber and thus the substrate. We use a volatile organometallic dimethyl zinc precursor, followed by in-cycle oxygen plasma treatment. The latter coreactant is not only to remove any remaining ligands on the surface, but also to compensate the oxygen need of the transition metal oxide layer. Let me share our in-situ spectroscopic ellipsometry data, which were acquired during 100 times repeated aforementioned zinc oxide atomic layer deposition recipe. The change in the psi were here shown at the selected wavelengths of 450 nanometer, 550 nanometer, and 650 nanometer. The time evolutions of the change in the delta data at the same selected wavelengths are also shown here. It is important to note that the presented each data points in the time evolution of both psi and delta figures possess a spectral evolution ranging from 1.7 eV all the way up to 4 eV. Moreover, the dynamic Dewbach model takes into account all those data in the best match model calculations. The amount of data can be counted as a proof for the viability and correctness of our model to describe the observed changes in the optical properties of transition metal oxide films during the atomic layer deposition processes. It is clear from the inset zoom plots of the psi and delta that there exist monotonous oscillations. It is important to note that the observed wriggles or oscillations are not noise, but it appears as a consequence of cyclic surface modifications due to the introduction of each precursor to the sample surface. In the inset plots, we can also easily see the best match model calculations as black lines that are in an excellent agreement with the spectroscopic ellipsometry data. Let me take equally spaced time slices from the in situ spectroscopic ellipsometry data, which can be further employed in the multiple sample analysis approach to extract the dielectric function of the deposited zinc oxide ultrathin film, which then further will be used in our retroactive in situ data analysis as well. Here are the time slices from the in situ spectroscopic ellipsometry data. The selections were made by the end of each ALD cycle at which the surface is cleaned from the ligands of the main precursor. It is important to note that delta is mainly sensitive to the thickness changes, and psi is mainly related to the absorbance property of the thin films. Because of this reason, we observe constant shift in the delta value during the thin film deposition on the substrate. As seen from the figure, the best match model calculations are indicated by the green lines and have excellent agreement with the psi and delta data. Precise and accurate values for the transition metal oxide dielectric function are performed retroactively after the growth by analyzing the selected data sets acquired during the growth. The analysis is based on the concept of so-called multiple sample analysis. In this method, sets of spectroscopic ellipsometry data from the sets of thin films with different thickness values but equal dielectric function are used. And here is the corresponding dielectric function of zinc oxide ultrathin film obtained from the in-situ data-based multiple sample analysis method. As we said, our ultimate goal is to unravel the time-dependent observation of precursor surface interactions in the plasma-enhanced atomic layer deposition of zinc oxide ultrathin films with the capability to resolve the evolution of layer thickness and surface roughness during the separate steps of individual cycles by using in-situ spectroscopic ellipsometry data and dynamic Dewbach model. The extracted dielectric functions from the in situ multiple sample analysis method and the roughness thickness from the atomic force microscopy image analysis were employed in our dynamic dual box model approach. Hence, we can then retroactively fit transition metal oxide thickness and surface ligand layer void fraction parameters. From the inset, we can clearly observe the cyclic oscillations in both thin film thickness and void fraction rate. Let me share the in-cycle resolution in-situ spectroscopic ellipsometry-based thickness and void fraction rate evolutions, which are overlaid with both the schematic illustration of zinc oxide atomic layer deposition phases indicated with the cardinal numbers and cyan delta data at 550 nanometer. The hatched area on the left and right hand side are the outside of the selected ALD cycle. Obviously, each precursor application brings with itself a cyclic change in both ellipsometric data and therefore our dynamic parameters. To the best of our knowledge, unraveling the surface modifications during the in-cycle components of the zinc oxide ALD have not been reported, and our dynamic dual box model successfully unravels the in-cycle kinetics of such process. As seen from the thickness evolution, a net gain is obtained at the end of each cycle, which is measured to be approximately 1 angstrom, as the substrate temperature is measured to be 250 Celsius. Next, we would like to further extend our investigation through in situ spectroscopic ellipsometry database recipe optimization by studying the effect of substrate temperature on thickness gain. Here, by using our simplistic ALD recipe, we grow zinc oxide at different temperature values. We started with 150 Celsius and successfully deposited 75 cycles. Following that, we increased the temperature to 200 Celsius and waited enough to stabilize the temperature in the reactor chamber and deposited another 25 cycles. And repeated the same strategy for 250, 300, and 350 Celsius values. Here again, we selected multiple data points from the in-situ data and retroactively fit to obtain overall thickness for each temperature values. And thus, we can then extract the average growth per cycle data as a function of temperature. As seen from the corresponding plot, that the substrate temperature plays extreme tunability role in the thickness gain per cycle. As a complementary study, we also performed X-ray photoelectron spectroscopy for elemental identification of our fabricated thin films. We find that only zinc and oxygen are present in the film, with a chemical composition rate of 52.4% and 47.6% respectively. These values are excellent indicative of expected stoichiometry of zinc oxide thin films. Moreover, we also performed XRD measurements of our zinc oxide thin films fabricated on both silicon wafer and 500 nanometer silicon dioxide substrates. Both substrates were analyzed before and after the growth of zinc oxide ALD. And we observed the emergence of a peak in the spectrum which reveals a polycrystalline nature with Versides phase. And here is our conclusion. The optical properties of zinc oxide ultra-thin films were successfully extracted from the in-situ spectroscopic ellipsometry-based multiple sample analysis method. In-situ spectroscopic ellipsometry permits the time-dependent observation of precursor surface interactions in the plasma-enhanced atomic layer deposition of transition metal oxide thin films. Dynamic dual-box model-based in-situ spectroscopic ellipsometry data analysis paved the way through the investigation of atomic layer deposition in cycle kinetics. We show that the substrate temperature plays a fundamental role in the growth rate. The XPS results show that we successfully obtained the stoichiometrically expected zinc oxide thin films. The AFM image analysis and XRD scans of the growth films were also performed. And thank you very much for your listening. If there is any questions, I am more than happy to answer them.